not to cut the meat. If you cut some meat, happen to cut a little bit of the meat, that's fine, but don't make a point of that real slicing. So just a gentle, little, it's gonna aid in rendering the fat, because duck, you know, to a lot of people, they go, oh, it's too fatty. Well, it's very fatty. There's a lot of fat underneath the skin, subcutaneous, as they say. So in order to get rid of some of that fat, we render it slowly. And this helps because it gives access to the fat to get out of the pan. Okay, so salt. Salt also helps get some of the fat out. And I didn't have time this morning to finish it, but I made some of the confit orange slices. They're not quite sweet enough. The orange juice is really good. The orange is great. So we're going to emphasize the oranges. Okay, so pan, pull, in pan, turn on the machine, my glove, I'm not going to handle the raw meat. On it goes. It's kind of hard to gauge what's medium and not medium. So this is going to take a little bit of time. And in the process, somebody would ask if you wouldn't mind. So for the sauce, you guys will need a wafer X. This thing goes the other way, the actual right one.
Yeah.
Right. We're turning it the wrong way.
It does go the other way.
But even then, I mean, we weren't having any luck.
Yeah.
So I was here late last night, and this, she had to be close to 90. She was just walking around looking where she wanted to know where the cafeteria was. So I said, can I borrow you for a minute? She came in the kitchen, 90-year-old lady, and she just walked up there like that. So, you know, talk to us over. Okay, the magic is happening. We're just going to let it slowly render. In the meantime, here's my mise en place with the sauce. I have shallots, minced, or boudinois, some white pepper, freshly ground, some thyme, it's the last of the fresh, but I also have dried thyme. Dried thyme you got the other day is nice. Orange juice that you guys did yesterday, some orange supremes, so here's oranges that you guys will make nice pieces of orange. I have a little chive and a little thyme for garnish, no big deal. In that container there, you get the flambé a little bit. So there's brandy, rum, onion, and rum. That is all that is there. So that would be quite the night of the pit if you were to go that way for it. Now, some chicken stock that we made, butter, and here is the confit orange that we had. That I just gave it a shot, but you need to give it more time than I had. It's still a little bitter. But nonetheless, and you know, when you're making this, I mean, you should have your mise en place ahead of time, but very often, you know, you've got 4 or 5 minutes, it's going to be in the oven, and they're all set to 200 degrees Celsius or 390. And I can certainly take a look and see how we're doing, but don't be afraid, it's doing fine. We're looking for a nice golden brown, a beautiful duck breast. When you serve it, skin should be a beautiful golden brown. The fat should be rendered out. The skin should be kind of crispy, and we're looking for medium rare. Unless the guest specifies otherwise. For you guys today, you're not the guests. Medium rare. So your temperature with the thermometer, 125 is fine. In fact, maybe even a little too much, but 125 is a good benchmark. and then we let it rest. So I got a pan to let it rest in, and while it's resting, I make my sauce. So, you know, everything kind of comes out at the same time. Now, you know, typically if you're working in a restaurant, you're going to have many pans going at the same time. So you know, that's just something to become familiar with. It's a skill. And then you can see the fat's starting to pour out. You want to make sure it doesn't burn. So I'm, you know, don't be afraid of looking. That's fine. Again, I'm never sure about the heat on this. I'd be more comfortable over there, but this works out. Would somebody hand me, actually, no, I need a little pocket. I just need a little container to pour my duck fat. And we'll try to save the duck fat. It is really delicious to cook potatoes in or something. It's great. You know, in a classical kitchen, we don't throw anything away. Try not. Everything can be used. That plate that the chef made, oh, I bet that's $48. That's not an expensive restaurant.
Expediter, that's their job, is to tell you, cook, you know, start the duck breast now, start the steak now, because they have a feeling for, you know, they'll ask the server, how long do you think it's going to be, and they'll say, like you guys had, you know, like, how long do you think it's going to be for them to eat, because we need to know that. And you'll say, oh, they're really going slow, it'll be at least 10 minutes, and then we kind of, well, the duck breast is going to take 5 minutes here and 5 minutes in the oven, so the expediter will say, go ahead and start cooking your duck breast. And hopefully they're ready to eat if the time comes. Now, you know, in most restaurants, that timing is not all that crucial. But if you're in a place like we watched in the second video, it's everything. And, you know, they would start another one because, there's, you know, the guest says, oh, the guests have to get on the phone. It's a doctor and he's going to be back in 15 minutes. They're going to serve you a new duck breast because the first one is just not going to work out. Just the best. I served an order of, I was working at this club where I showed to the little French guy. And one night, we got a lot of celebrities, not so much celebrities, but dignitaries in the place. So I fed a lot of world leader kind of people. And one day, the Secret Service came in, and the president was eating that night. I'm gonna come in. He was at the UN, he's coming to dinner at the club. And they already check you out. They know who's around. President Reagan came in and ate, and he ordered the pigeon. And then all of a sudden, he got called on a phone call, and I was determined not to make a new one for him. So I reheated it. But he liked it.
Chef would have screamed at me if he knew that. It all works. I'm getting a little impatient because you guys are just
So I'm stepping it up just a bit, but don't burn it. So, you know, again, it's like a sixth sense, and you're just always watching it, and you know, but you've got other things going on. It would be the height of luxury to be making one duck roast, and that's your job at the restaurant. It's not enough. It's actually a little hard. Almost there. Then I'm going to sear it on the other side, and then turn it back on the skin side and pop it in the oven. So actually, that's pretty good. You know, the black is the pepper, so that's a nice golden brown. I'm just going to sear it. Now I didn't trim this at all. Some of them might have skin hanging out a little bit. You trim it a little bit, but the more you trim it, the more likely the skin's going to shrink up and it's not going to cover the surface of the top. You kind of want that there. Okay. Turn it over. In the oven it goes. The clock is running.
I'm just going to look at it.
Now I can't do anything until the duck comes out.
And the oven's at 200?
It's at 390, 200 Celsius.
Oh, they were talking Celsius. Yeah. Okay. Those burners.
You guys all have pretty good experience with making orange supremes, you know, peeling the skin and just getting the sections out. Should I give a demo on that for the,
demo.
The 4 minutes?
Okay. We got those ones.
This is Zane's work, so we have extra. If you can't see very well anymore, you put your glasses on. So I'm going to cut the top and the bottom off. And when I do that, trying to line up the other side so they're equally flat. And then the first one's the toughest cut. Now I can see where I'm going, so I'm just gently peeling the just underneath the white, keeping it as round as we can, so as many slices as we need.
So are we all cooking our own stuff first?
Yeah. In fact, you're going to do it twice. And hopefully the second one comes out better than the first one. And yeah, I should have a glove on. Paring knife is ideal for this. I just used to use it. That's sharp. All the fingers are supposed to go in the things, right?
Yep.
Sometimes I get that. All right, then you just, you know, you pick it up. This is pretty good, except for this one little piece right here. And then you just, in between what do we call this?
Pivot.
No, the pith is the white part.
Ribs.
Oh, yeah. I know there's a name for it. Section pieces. And these oranges are good. And amazingly, when you get to the end of this, amount of juice left when you think you took all the orange out. So definitely get juice out of your sauces. Okay, so just for demonstration purposes, even after you took all the orange out, quite a bit of juice. You gotta know how sweet it is. So to that point, I tasted it, so I knew it was good. But if it's
extra sweet, I brought some vinegars to balance it out. That's the sweet and sour. And then we're talking about the agro dolce in Italian, the agro dum in French. If it needs more, if it's not sweet enough, we add some sugar to it. But these are pretty good. All right, let's see how it goes.
Hey.
Of course, you always carry your towel with you. I'm perfectly, I tend to love it. Nope. 2 more minutes. Questions? This is such a trick to be able to
What's do. What's the
What? 125. Second guy, he added even rarer than the first guy. But that's the deal. That's, you know, customers at that type of restaurant will be expecting that. Now, I would suspect perhaps if you served rare duck breast in the cafeteria, that would be freaky. But, you know, but just it's not like chicken. You just have to explain that to me. It's not. Really good. You're gonna love it. I like this class because I really like this prepared thing. You don't come eating duck, and it's delicious. Okay, I'm gonna say it's gonna be about exactly 91 seconds from now. Let's just see how this came out. I'll cut it up. You guys can try it. So this is skin. When I supremed an orange this morning, I took the skin off. Took more of the pith off than I was concerned about taking all the pith off when I made the supreme, but I couldn't have that much white. So I went back over it again. I boiled it 3 times, just in water, to soften it and to get some of the bitterness out. And then I made essentially a simple syrup and cooked it in that, but it needs a little bit more time than I had to do. So here's something to try out. It would be a little less bitter if I had more time. That's the comfy orange. And you know, it's a great use if you're doing grapefruits, you know, and you're supreming it. It's fantastic with grapefruit skin.
Ooh,
then
that
you just
good.
Sprinkle some sugar over the top and it dries off, you get candy. That's a candy fruit deal. Right, Chef?
Yeah.
And people love
it. I asked for mine extra crispy. I like it crispy.
All right, questions are real. Yeah. Oh, there you go. Okay. All right. So now, I'm just going to let it rest inside the pot. Pour the fat off a little bit. I want to get some of the black peppercorns, but I don't want to lose all this fawn that's in the bottom. I also don't want to screw up the pan. I'm just getting rid of some of the peppercorns. Okay. Get them off. All the flavors in the pan. Get it on the fire again. Hello? Hello, fire?
You need the thingy.
Chef to the rescue.
What'd you do, Chef?
Am I just being dying off?
Oh, there we go. Okay, hand on the fire. It's hot. The handle's screaming hot, so at your side towel. I'm going to put a little booze in there, which I have. So about, it's like less than an ounce. Let that blow.
Oh.
Let that blow. That's how it's going. Okay. So I'm going to put a little piece of butter my shallots go in. Cook my shallots until they're soft. I could add my thyme. A little bit of white pepper. Okay. Okay. So it's, you know, pretty dry. I'm going to add some of the chicken stock we made the other day. Let's say about double what I did of the so like a full cup of this. And I'm just going to let that reduce down. Hopefully it's going fast. Now we're getting to the fun part.
Ooh, that smells good.
All right, starting to do this thing. So chicken stock, you know, if I had duck stock, great. Chicken stock is fine. It's the all-purpose. Ooh, it smells good. I like that thyme smell. It's like my favorite bourbon. All right, I'm going to add a little orange juice, about equal amount to what we did with the chicken stock.
What was that for the chicken stock?
Orange juice. And I'm just going to bring it over there because I get more power. And we're just reducing it down to almost marmalade, just like they have in the video. Pretty darn dry, but not completely. Then we're going to do what they call monte au beurre, to mount with butter. And we're going to emulsify the liquid with the butter, cold butter in the warm sauce, and we'll get a sauce on it. Right at the moment. So I'm going full blast if I wanted to reduce. Yeah,
it's staring at butter.
You know, and when we don't have very much liquid in here in the first place, so you gotta be paying attention because that'll go to zero. Don't think I can go to the bathroom and come back. Even the walk-in. Okay. Someone will say, "Chef, what about this? Or did you do that?" Go, well, let me check on that. Then you come back and the pan is zero. Almost
zero. So much.
And you know, in itself, it's getting thicker at the same time. And I'm not straining this, you could, but I like that beautiful time we use in the pepper. Almost there. Now, since you guys are here, if someone would grab the butter for me and the spoons, that would be helpful.
So,
no, it's all, you can see it's all kind of dry
right now.
Yeah. Okay, so now I'm going to talk to you a touch of the real world here, at least in the old, a touch of the real world. So I want to see what this kind of tastes like right now, so I know if you need salt, pepper, maybe you need some sugar. I could be tempted to go to sugar. Probably in the real world. I need a little sugar. I don't know if I had it yet. Just, I mean, like a tiny little bit.
She's just walking across.
There's sugar right there.
Oh, thank you.
You got it.
It's a race. It's all right to share.
She went to the bakery.
Perfect. Thank you. So I'm talking like, that's what matters. Okay, now, kind of off the flame and on the flame, I'm going to start taking pieces of butter. This is our breakfast butter, so we're going to begin to use it up. And we're going to emulsify the butter right into the pan. Now, Chef Brew, he's into like it has to boil. I was talking a little differently, but the goal is to get a sauce
it's not broken, so that, you know, it doesn't look like the hollandaise. It has to look like a homogeneous, creamy sauce. And you know, you work it on the fire, you take it off the fire, we're just trying to get it. It's going to need a little salt. You don't really want it to boil. Because you know, if you add the butter, it's diluting it. It's delicious.
So, Chef, you have it back, excuse me, you have it back on the plane, and now you've added butter?
Yes.
And a little sugar.
And, well, to taste. I thought I needed it, and that's good. Okay, so I'm just going to let it sit there a moment. I'm going to come over here. I'm going to cut my duck. I got my plate. You don't want to cut it too thin because it gets cold. That looks great. Sauce. And you want to let it rest or look good? And luckily it's cold. See, so not broken. Just a nice sauce. You never know that. Alright, now you guys get to eat. Yeah, we'll cut it in half if you need. I got a little bit of chives.
So you don't put the sauce on the duck, you just put it around?
No, you want people, the sauce, it'll get soggy. You could put a little drizzle if you want, yeah. But yeah, you want people to see that the duck is, that's the color that they're looking for. Try the sauce, try a piece of duck.
Mm-hmm.